Hey, Colin here from Photoshop Cafe, and I'm really excited to let you know there's a whole bunch of new features Adobe's just dropped into Photoshop. This release is called CC 2015.5. All right, I'm now going to show you my five favorite features in CC 2015.5 of Photoshop. Number one, we've got a better way of extracting images. So the old refine edge has been replaced. So let's just grab our selection brush. And we're going to use our quick selection brush, and we're going to make a quick selection around here. Now, just to let you know, I'm going to move through these five tutorials very quickly, and I've actually created more in-depth videos of these, and I'll put a link to the bottom, and I'll also put a link at the end of this section to those videos. So now, instead of choosing the refine edge, we choose select and mask. The big thing in here is we've now got this onion skin view, which means that we can take the transparency all the way down. You can see the unextracted image, or you can see the fully extracted image. Now this is useful because we can kind of fade it in a little bit, so we can get a little hint of where certain things are, and so we can include them. So we're going to use our refine brush here. Notice if I go around the hairs, see how it starts to pick that up? Let's just go around that edge there, and you can see it's actually getting the individual hairs now. It's just so much better than the tool was in the past. And let me just go in here. And like I said, I'm just going to tear through this. So it's probably not going to be perfect. I'm not going to show you all the options, but I'm going to go into that in my other video that I created. I just want you to get an overview of what's new and what's cool. All right, so I'm just making these little selections around here, around the edges of the hair, because I want to just cut that out. And as you can tell, this is a difficult hair to extract because, you know, it's curly. It's not just, you know, simple, easy, straight hair. And let's have a look at that. If we go all the way down, you can see we've got some individual hairs nicely selected in there. You know, we can go through and refine these ones individually and just get them bang on. But what we're going to do is we're going to output this to a new layer for layer mask. I'm going to choose decontaminate colors. This does a really great job of just getting the extras. And you can see there we're able to cut out that hair pretty quickly. And let's move on to number two. Number two here is the Face Aware Liquify. This is a crazy tool. It's a lot of fun. So let's have a look at how it works. We're going to go under Filter. We're going to go to Liquify. And what it's going to do is it's actually going to detect the faces on here. And as you can see here, look at that. It's detected those individual faces. And you can see we can select the five faces from there. It knows where they are. And to select a face, we can either use the On Control here, which I show you in the other tutorial, or we can just select there and notice it says, hey, this is face three. So we can adjust things like the eye size and different things there. Or we can do this right on screen. So we can make these eyes a little wider. We can change the angle of them. As you can see there, we can even click on them and move them around if we want to. Same thing with the nose. We can bring the nose up. We can make it narrower, make it wider. You can see we can have a lot of fun with this. We can even go here. We can make the mouth bigger or smaller. And we can even make people smile. So we can have a lot of fun with this. Let's move the chin up a little bit. And you can see, let's select the second one right here. We can change him. Notice the eyes work together. And as you can see there, we can just have so much fun with this, just liquefying these faces, making the mouth smaller, bigger. Hello. And, you know, make them smile, make them upset, etc. So you can see all that. There's different like presets and things like that. And I'll actually show you how to turn someone into a celebrity in my other one. So there we go, before and after, Face Aware Liquify is number two. Let's have a look at number three. The number three, you've probably seen some of the sneaks that have been leaked from Adobe, and that's the Content Aware Crop. So notice that this image is crooked. This is something I shot at Laguna on my drone. So I'm going to grab the crop tool to straighten this. Now if I grab the straighten tool here and drag it across, it's going to want to rotate this around. Now, because you rotate it around, notice there's edges here. Let me turn that off. So that will constrain it into that area. Notice it's going to crop it down right there normally to fit within the boundaries. But we're losing the palm tree there. We're losing a lot of different things. So if we turn on Content Aware, it will actually enable it to get larger and include these different areas in there. You know, we can, oops, didn't want to do that. We can even, you know, pull it all the way to the edge to encompass all this area. Could go larger if you wanted. And then what it's going to do, these areas would normally be transparent, so it would be all kind of crooked and you'd have to crop it in. But turning on Content Aware, we hit enter, and it's actually going to crop this. Look at that. And it uses Content Aware Fill to automatically fill in those corners so that we've got our nice image looking like that. Awesome. So that's three. Let's move on to number four. Number four, I'm actually going to do a little bit of a double kind of a thing on this one. So what this does is it enables us to identify fonts. If you ever looked at something and said, you know, I wonder what that font is. Well, what we can do is make a selection here around this bit of type. And we're going to move up here under where it says type. And under type, we're going to use match font. So what it's actually going to do is it's going to look on my system now and see what similar fonts I have to this. But also, it goes out onto Typekit. So you can see on Typekit here, it's looking for similar ones. And even notice this has even got the outline. So it's even looking for outline fonts as well. And you can see, you know, we've kind of got this type of font looking. Now, if you want to do it to an individual letter, we can just change the selection here. And you'll notice this will change a little bit. So sometimes you want to move over a certain particular character or whatever, and you might get a better look at what it is you're looking for. So let's just make that a little smaller. And, you know, it looks like, hey, this one called Imprint is looking pretty good. Okay. So why don't we go up under the font, under Imprint, and see what it looks like. So if we go under Imprint, there's that font right there, but here's a new feature that will enable you to narrow this down even more. Is if we select here, it chooses similar fonts. So look at this. Now we've got all these fonts in the same family that are on my system, and it will even go out to Typekit, and it'll show you other fonts of that same family that are similar, so you can actually nail it down and find the font you want. So that's number four. Number five is really simple. It's just a small fix, but I know a lot of people have been complaining about it. And a lot of retouchers are going to be, yahoo, they're going to be very happy about this. Healing brush. A lot of people have not been happy with the new healing brush behavior, and they just wanted to go back to the old one. So what we can do now is under Photoshop, which would be File Preferences on Windows, go down to Tools. Under Tools there, we're going to see there's an option to do the legacy algorithm for the healing brush. So this will actually bring you back the healing brush of how it used to work. So if you're not happy with that, you can just turn that on, and now your healing brush will work just like it has in the past. So all right, that was a quick roundup of my five favorite features inside of Photoshop CC 2015.5. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget, check out the Learning Center where I've got a ton more information. I've also got more in-depth tutorials on some of these new features, so check that out as well. So thanks for joining us. Don't forget, hit that subscribe button. If you enjoy what we're doing here, subscribe. Every week I'm doing at least one new tutorial. I don't want you to miss out on it, so join in with the Cafe crew. Become a Cafe crew by just hitting that subscribe button. Thanks a lot, guys. And don't forget, comment, add a like, and until next time, I'll see you at the Cafe.